I'd like to introduce myself. I'm Towns Van Zandt, and this is my dog Geraldine here. Geraldine, come here.
Oh, Loretta, she's my barroom girl. Wears them sevens on her sleeve. Dances like a diamond shines. Tells me lies I love to believe.
Towns' father bought him a guitar when he was a young boy, with the condition that he learned Fraulein, an old German folk song. And I think the desire to get a guitar came about after Towns saw Elvis on the Ed Sullivan Show. And saw all the girls going crazy. He wanted to learn guitar and sing. He was like, that's what I want to do. And then after some time of really serious practice and got good with finger picking, and he started realizing, I think, through Bob Dylan's first album that you could write songs about human emotion from just about any perspective you wanted to.
Well, won't you lend your lungs to me? Mine are collapsing.
Towns approached the song with a very serious sort of ethic, work ethic about him. He would sit down determined to write a song. He wouldn't get up until he had completed that task. My mom tells stories that he would go in the closet, literally. He had a little closet he treated like an office that was only about 4 feet by 2 feet. And he had a little desk built in one side. And he would go in there, and one day he was in there for, you know, over a couple days solid before he came out, and he wrote Waiting Around to Die and a couple others actually in the closet.
Well, sometimes I don't know where this dirty road is taking me. Sometimes I can't even see the reason why. I guess I'll keep a gambling. Lots of booze and lots of rambling. It's easier than just to wait around to die.
I would say this year is justice with him being inducted. When I first moved to Austin, I went into the Soap Creek Saloon on South Congress, and I heard Towns Van Zandt. There maybe were 30, 40 people there. I walked out of there different than when I walked in.
He was just a real treasure as a guy. And there's so many elements to what Towns did that people didn't always see. And I remember one time we did a writer's night with Guy, Billy Joe, Towns, and myself at the Bluebird. And we were playing blues, and Towns busted into playing the blues, and he sounded just like Lightnin' Hopkins. I was like, wow, how'd he do that? It's great.
I think he carried it with him. There was a lot of, back then in Texas, you learned your manners. You know, yes ma'am, no ma'am, when to talk, when to be quiet. But from a kind, gentle perspective, you know, it was rough and rugged, but also tenderness, like towards animals and the environment, things like that. I think it always carried with him wherever he went. People would tell me, hey, he's got really good manners. I'm like, yeah, you don't know him well.
The big stories are always about how he fell off stage or how he played the saxophone, went to a pawn shop and bought a saxophone or something like that. I saw really, truly great shows that Towns played. I mean, really great, sober shows, a real window into great songwriting and getting to see it right firsthand.
The name she gave was Caroline.
I think Towns' ability to put himself into the specific emotion that he was writing about, it was such an inseparable sort of meditation that he really arrived at central human emotion approach. And I think that's what makes him so special.
Well, if I needed you, would you come to me? Would you come to me and ease my pain? If you needed me, I would come to you.
The way Towns put words together is unlike anyone else. At least for me, you know, it changed everything about the way I viewed writing. He's got like 42 words and tells an entire novel.
Towns is just an important songwriter who helped to teach me what a song could be, in the same way that Guy Clark and his writing helped teach me what a song could be. Songs could be descriptive, and they could be poetic, and didn't have to just be one catchy line or phrase after another.
He had a rare talent, but he also worked very, very hard to write those songs and to put himself in a place to create the music that he did. So focus on Towns' music and the achievement of what his work, you know, the impact that it's had on society, and especially on Texas. I think that's a much better place to think of Towns than any stories that may or may not even be true. So just love the music, and if you haven't heard it, go and buy it and listen to it. And I think it'll definitely have a positive impact on your life.
Well, shake the dust off of your wings and the tears out of your eyes.